All right, everybody on YouTube, you know the routine. We always show up with you guys first. This is a special Tuesday night edition of the show, so don't be shocked. Ladies and gentlemen, a special election 2016 Cave Radio Special. Tuesday night it is. Cave tonight, watching the election with all of you. My name is DK, and I will be your moderator, I guess would be my term tonight, the moderator of the election. Over to New York.
Well, live from New York, this is Sir Big B on this historic night. For all of us here in the United States, I am prepared, if you can see, I have my bowl of popcorn, I have my glass of whiskey, and I have a frosty beverage. So I can see, I can have a front row seat to the fall of an empire.
This is beer, whiskey,
and popcorn.
And popcorn.
I am ready for the fall of the empire tonight. We are done as a superpower.
I think I told you, we're trying to connect with England, by the way, folks, so you have a truly international special. You're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't. You're fucked up the ass either way. But let's have some fun with it.
And I have an announcement.
Hang on. I'm not at the announcement board. I'm still working on England.
Okay,
what was the one we decided on? Was it this one? That'll do for now.
Okay. Kansas was just called, and it's called for Donald Trump.
So now, is that a win or a loss?
That is a win for Donald Trump.
I realize that, but again, you got to remember I'm in Canada, right?
Oh, right. Oh, and just called now, North Dakota for Donald Trump and South Dakota for Donald Trump.
Okay, but can you explain to me, are these traditionally Republican or
Nebraska Democrat? Just called for Donald Trump as well. Yes, they are traditionally red states. Red states is the Republican. You have red states and blue states. Blue states is the Democrat. Red states is the Republican. So these are traditionally red states. So not a big surprise. Right now, the three major swing states, now these are states that could go, in any election, they could go either way, and they carry a lot of electoral votes. Florida, North Carolina, and Ohio are all too close to call at the moment.
Still too close. But he's still in the lead.
Right? I'm sorry?
He's in the lead.
He's in the lead in Florida. I haven't seen the numbers yet for North Carolina and Ohio. I think they're still waiting on polling precincts to come in. They just called Texas as well for Donald Trump. Again, a typically red state.
The land of George Bush.
Right. Not a big surprise that Donald Trump has taken Texas.
I just want to do a quick check over to London. Can you hear us yet? London.
Did you mute him?
You're there. Right. We'll check in with you in a few minutes.
He's kind of sort of there.
So at this point on Cave Crew Radio, we are not prepared to call this election.
No, this election will go on for a while tonight. What most likely will happen is we won't be able to call it until tomorrow morning, especially if Florida is extremely, what happens in Florida, if it's very, very, very close within a certain like one percentage point, they will recount the votes. So that could go on till tomorrow morning.
That kind of fucks up our show, doesn't it?
It does, but we can still have fun with it.
Yes, of course we can.
Now, either way, we are. I'm sorry?
No, no, I had to move away from the mic. But what I was going to tell you was, while we're waiting for England to
London calling.
Yes, London, we hear you.
Does London hear us?
Yeah. I just had a little bit of a technical issue there. Rushing home from work, getting the beers in. What is all this about? An erection show?
No, not an erection show, Stu. It's an election show.
Stu was getting himself all excited and all prepared for the erection show. He wanted to show off his manhood to everybody.
Oh, my pressure. God.
I've got all sorts of lubes out and stuff like that, and I'm just thinking I just might not be able to join in tonight.
I'll tell you what, Stu, with all your sorts of lubes, you may have to send some over to us here in the U.S. because we're about to take it up the ass no matter who wins. Let me tell you.
And Stu, I want to make you a promise that we'll do an erection story before we...
sorry to be late to the party.
You're always late to the party. You had audio Tourette's or something going on over there. I think you guys got too much smog or something going on since you guys left Brexit. They're like poisoning you people. Because, I mean, you got the hiccups in the middle of the show.
I don't know. But I've got my Brexit top on, so I'm fingers crossed for Trump tonight.
Stu, I'd like to see Trump win too.
And that segues nicely into what I kind of wanted to lead off the show with you guys. Obviously, Stu's in the UK. DK, you're in Canada. So it doesn't directly affect you as it would me living here in the US. But are you guys paying a lot of attention to the election? Do you really care who wins? What's the thoughts in your countries for this election?
Do you want me to go first, Stu?
Yeah, go for it, DK.
All right, I'll go first because us being your neighbor.
The neighbor to the north.
Like Scotland would be to England type of thing. Look, our national news right now is broadcasting the American election. So Ottawa, our capital, could be on fire, and the world is watching. Let's face it.
Right.
You are the powerhouse of the free world. We all work together, but I mean, it's almost like Big Brother.
Right.
So the only reason we liked Obama, I think I said it before, was because he didn't do anything bad or good. Not even sure if the guy had balls. But with Clinton, everything's always good with a Democratic president as far as the economy goes. Mm-hmm. We are definitely afraid of World War III.
And that is how Clinton has been posturing at least a standoff with Russia all through this email scandals from WikiLeaks saying, oh, Russia hacked us. Russia did this. Russia did that. You really don't want to fuck with Putin and Russia. I know we won the Cold War, but Gorbachev was a moderate. He didn't want to fight anybody. He wanted peace. And him and Reagan worked together to tear down the wall and bring peace. And we ultimately won the Cold War. Putin don't fuck around. You want to stand off with Putin, you're going to lose. and we're going to wind up speaking Russian in this country.
Yeah. If he wants to blow up the Middle East, let him. There are enemies too. Just don't take the oil.
Sorry, yeah.
Right.
Anyway, England, how do you feel? Sorry, Stu. We always leave you out.
Well, as we've got, World War III.
Do you understand a word?
Well, now we know why we leave Stu out. You are breaking up badly.
He has, and write this down for your fucking show notes, extraterrestrial Tourette's. It affects everything he does.
It really does.
Okay, I'm going to give it another try.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to give it another try. As we're voted out of Brexit over here, does that get us out of World War III?
I don't think so.
I think you'd be a prime target.
Oh yeah, we still want you to be our number one backup. We say, all right, we're going to go to war. England, you're with us. Let's go.
So at the allotment, I still need to keep digging under the shed to get that base.
Yeah, get your and you know, it's really bad, folks, when we get used to this, and I can read what he's saying. You probably didn't understand a word. Does he still have to dig a bomb shelter in his allotment? I don't know if you got that out of that, Big B, but that's going to be what we're running with right now.
That's exactly what I got.
Let's put it this way. I think that England or Great Britain or whatever it is classified as in France and probably Germany would be toast before the bread's even warm on our side of the ocean.
Probably. Putin will just come and lay waste to Europe.
Well, you know he's going to hit there first. It's a lot easier than going through all the space shit the Americans have. And
well, that's true. I mean, that's true. At least we'll put up a fight, least a little bit of a fight before, you know, Russia wins. Europe, he can just roll over.
Interesting poll for you out there in the Cave Crew Radio audience. Why don't you tell us what species do you think will survive World War III? After it begins, probably shortly after Christmas and Hanukkah.
I wanted to show you too. I don't know if you can see here.
A little over. Oh, that's your "I voted" sticker.
Yes, they hand out these stupid little stickers whenever you vote. So I got a sticker.
I wonder if they're going to sell on eBay for like people from England and Canada and Australia that
I guarantee somebody's going to hold on to their sticker. I mean, I don't care. I'm throwing mine away. I don't give a shit. But somebody's going to hold on to their sticker and sell it because this is what everybody's calling an historic election, regardless of who wins.
I think you should send the sticker to Choo Choo Stu if he can utter a sentence without falling into extraterrestrial Tourette's. That's really hard to say. Extraterrestrial Tourette's.
Extraterrestrial Tourette's.
Right, I'm going to put my hand up now when I want to speak, okay? Because I don't know what's happening with this bandwidth and stuff like that. It seems to be, I don't know.
I don't know in England if you have a thing called shorthand, but it's like a way of writing. Obviously, I don't think they do it anymore because we're all computerized now, but secretaries used to write by shorthand. So if you could like get your point across in 6 words or less, we think we can, you know, understand what you're saying. That's before the satellite throws the signal at you.
Just to shut the fuck up.
The one thing that comes in clear.
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
Okay. Stu, I want to know one thing, Stu. What technological year is it by you? Is it 1988 where you have a dial-up modem? What are you guys doing over there?
Could you just technology? Stop trying to phone people? Sorry. Yeah. we're on the 1995 dial-up here. No, I don't know what's happened. The last few weeks, it's been really dodgy. And trying to get through to my internet company is very hard, you know. So I'm stuck with it at the moment. All I can blame it on is Canada at the moment.
Look, my TV went down for 3 days and my internet was still going. We got good internet here. I'm on a good thing here. Anyway, Stu, that's great, and we'll talk about the washing repairman in a minute. But I think it's time for a Big B update. Well, that's a great update.
That is a wonderful update. Right now, Trump is ahead in the electoral vote, 139 to 97. Trump is also ahead in Florida, 49.2% to 47.7%, with 93% of the vote in.
So that vote really hasn't moved in Florida. It was like a 90 when we came on air.
It takes a while to do Florida. That's why I said Florida will probably run into tomorrow morning if it's that close.
So for us, in layman's,
maybe you're not supposed to eat popcorn during your updates.
I'm watching the fall of the empire. I have my popcorn, my whiskey, and my beer.
Okay, well, listen, what is going on? So that to me seems like a big lead, but we're still too early to call.
We're still too early to call. The difference is 131,000 votes. And in election speak, that's like, 2-1, basically. You know, if you're counting, if there's four people or five people there and somebody has a 2-1 advantage right now, you know, with two to go, it's very, you don't know.
Sorry, go ahead. I was just going to say, was it not Al Gore who won the, the actual vote in 2000, but the other president had more electoral seats. So the vote really is nothing, right?
Right. So, right. Al Gore won. I guess it was the 2000 popular vote, but George Bush won the electoral vote. Yeah. And the electoral vote is the only thing that matters. Popular vote means absolutely nothing. So as we all say here in this country, our vote don't mean shit.
All right. Unless you're one of those big money spenders. All right, let's check to an election related story. I sent this to you guys. There was a psychic Scottish goat, so over in Stu's part of the world. He predicted Hillary Clinton would win the election. So the goat says Hillary's going to take this baby home. The Scottish goat. This revelation, I guess, comes just days after a Chinese monkey predicted that Trump would win.
Of course.
So now the debate becomes, I should probably check in the chat room once in a while here. Do we believe the monkey or the goat? London, this would be a good one for you to chime in on. This has nothing to do with reality. Coming from your higher powers out in the stars, Alpha Centauri, where you're getting your extraterrestrial powers that you just haven't honed in yet, like a Doctor Strange or something. Who's going to win, the monkey or the goat?
You talking to me?
You know what? We should do a remake of the Three Stooges on YouTube. I don't know if you'd be Larry or Curly. I really don't.
Oh, my God. You would definitely be Mo, DK. You would have to be.
All right, I'm skipping Stu on this one. You're just entertaining. Just stick around, Stu. Even the little bit you put in, every line is gold. Big B, monkey or the goat? Who would you trust?
Who would I think, trust?
Think of it in nature's way. How does a goat behave? A monkey's kind of wild, forges for itself, but very human-like.
Very human-like. Goats are docile animals that eat that eat paper.
Okay, you can't die because I can't hold a show with Choo Choo for another hour.
That's what happens when I eat popcorn and drink whiskey. God. So I would say that the goat, because it does eat paper, I think it was just trying to eat the Hillary sign. So I don't think that's a, I don't think that's a vote for Hillary. So I'm going with the monkey.
Now, see, that's a very critical point. I didn't think of that. The goat decided by chewing on a piece of paper. So the goat may basically be saying, you slut whore.
It's garbage. I'm going to eat you and shit you out, basically, what the goat said.
Yeah.
It doesn't tell us the story of the monkey. How did he... He turned and kissed the... They had two... You know, one was Hillary and one was Donald. Mm-hmm. And he kissed the Donald cutout.
Wonderful.
Let's go over to our stew cam. This is becoming the best part of Choo Choo Stew, is placing him on the stew cam.
Does he even know he's on cam? That's my question.
I know it. I can hear everything you're saying. And
he really is like Rain Man.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay. You know what? When I see Stu do this, and we'll keep going to the Stu cam, this is going to be bigger than that Matthew McConaughey movie we were talking about the other day. Time.
Right. Ed TV.
I think we need to get a GoPro, which is something they use a lot in sports, mm-hmm. and mount it on Stu and have a 24-hour Stu cam.
We absolutely need one of those. We need a...
Now, if you... Hey, is that okay? Can you hear me?
Yes, we
can. Yeah. Remember, six words or less.
I'm trying to log on another laptop, and I've forgotten my Facebook account, which where I've got the hangouts invitation.
He doesn't remember his password. He's the most... This is why you're still a fucking intern.
All of my passwords are on this bit of paper, and they're all very specially done. Like, you know what I mean, and even I can't remember.
The other thing we could do if we don't want to turn this into the stew cam, we can make this into a show.
A what?
I never put any. Email addresses, which was my full down, really. People can't remember me either. So I'm a little bit fucked at the moment. So I'm just trying to hack into my own Facebook account at the moment.
Own Facebook account.
I don't care if there is one or not. We're going to go to a breaking news update.
The electoral vote is now Trump 139, Clinton 104. I don't know what state went to Hillary, but is now 139 to 104. For those of you that don't know, that are outside of the country, the number of electoral votes needed to win is 270. Trump is at 139, right. Clinton at 104.
So he's over halfway there, but... Not that I know a lot about American politics, but again, I've lived. Oh, Stu, now I'm echoing on his laptop. You're a treat. Anyway.
I'll cut the microphone for a minute.
Okay, we don't really give a shit at this point. We're doing a breaking news, and then we'll cut back to the Stu cam, and we'll all have a Giro together.
Oh, my goodness.
Anyway, is it true, Big B, though, that certain states carry a lot of weight?
Certain states carry a lot of weight. That is correct. That is why we are talking about the swing states of Ohio, North Carolina, and Florida. Those states carry a lot of weight.
I would think California and New York would carry the bulk of it.
Oddly, they do not. It is those swing states... that really are the proving grounds for all presidents, and Iowa to a certain extent as well. But right now, from what I'm seeing, as far as the three swing states that we've been talking about, North Carolina, Florida, and Ohio, Trump is in the lead in all three. But again, all three are too close to call at the moment.
All right. And what was the other one? Virginia? And there's nothing from Michigan.
Nothing from Michigan yet. I think they just closed, so it'll take a while for them to.
That is a big Democratic. Both.
That is a big Democratic state, but that is a state that Trump has a chance to turn red.
Well, this is what I was going to tell you, because I don't know if you get, I'm sure it was on national media, but yeah. I get Michigan news like crazy. Hillary, Bill, President deported, whatever he's called now. Obama was at the University of Michigan. Yep. Donald Trump was there. Stu, mute your frickin'. It's almost funny. Anyway, they were all speaking in Michigan on the very last day. And I know they were in North Carolina. I know they were in Florida. They, you know, the miles those planes must put on in a day. Big B.
Oh, they were both doing like, you know, four or five states in a day, right at the very end. And Michigan, you know, you said that everybody was there. That is historically a Democratic state, but that's turning out to be a very possible Trump state. That is why both of them are there.
And the reason why is Ford's, Chrysler's, GM. There's now some big pharmaceutical company there. There's that that tax group, the group that does the tax program there. They've got a lot of head offices because it's a very attractive place right now. And I don't want to be accused of being prejudiced right now, but what they said on the news before I came down here was that Michigan has a, like, 10% bigger black population than Ohio.
Yep.
So they're thinking Democrat.
But that's the thing. Obviously, Michigan has been decimated by the auto industry leaving, you know, in Detroit and all that stuff. You're well aware of that because you're right there. What Trump said sits well with those voters. That he's going to bring jobs back. He's going to, you know, if these companies want to up the companies that are there now, if they want to up and move to Mexico, he's going to tax the shit out of them. You know, that sits well with those people. They need their jobs there. That state's been decimated, and Obama's done absolutely nothing for them. So you talk about the black vote. The black vote historically has been Democrat, always has been. But now there's a seeing what Obama has done, which is absolutely nothing, and then, you know, looking back on history, that Democrats are all in, you know, all about the black vote at voting season. But then after that, they don't give a shit anymore. I think the black
vote is. I want to interrupt. Can I just real quick?
Yep.
I gotta turn everyone who is on Cave Crew Radio TV. If you're on audio, we'll try to explain it to you. Choo Choo Stew.
No.
Up all his stuff, and he's echoing again, of course, and he's moving it.
Is that the kitchen?
Do you understand now why his wife won't curtains? I really, and again, I apologize to you people out there on TuneIn and CaveCrewRadio.com, but sometimes you got to come to the station, man. I'm telling you. Choo Choo Stew has been having audio problems to develop the extraterrestrial Tourette's. This is our other big news story of the night. Oh. Besides, you know, the fate of the free world, we're more worried about Choo Choo Stew. His wife's been after him to get curtains, folks. And we were giving him a hard time. You know, stand your ground, Stew. All that good stuff with your white leather furniture and your bamboo dinette set. But the curtains need to go. Are they fucking Korean or what are they? Look, he's posing in front of
the curtains. Stu, I'm going to take my last sip of whiskey. This is for you. I know you can't hear me. I don't know if you can see me, but this is for you.
He can hear us because he's dancing at the curtains. Ladies and gentlemen, the Stu Cam. This is by far... our biggest victory as a show ever. We tried to sell tomatoes. We've tried to make you laugh. We don't need to make you laugh. Sounds like a fucking
Can we sell sponsorships for this?
I sound like General MacArthur, right?
We need to sell sponsorships for the StuCam.
How come I'm echoing you or not?
I don't know. I don't hear you echo.
Stu is now dancing. Okay, here's something I want to do before we... I don't know if we're going to get Jerry or not. I'm going to ping him in a minute. But listen, the StuCam, everybody. We're going to keep it on the StuCam for a minute. But we're going to take a very short, like 30-second break here. I'm just going to put a tune on or something. You're listening to the Cave Crew Radio Election Special right here on CaveCrewRadio.com and Cave Crew Radio TV. Seems to be the way things are moving in this show. Special Tuesday night American election special is what we've got for you tonight. And we'll be back in about 2 seconds with a update from our updater, the Big B. He's gladly taking on that position tonight for us. And we'll keep you also updated on the StuCam. Because Lord knows he doesn't contribute audibly. Anyway, hang on. Let me. What song should we play? Here's a good one. This one goes out to no matter which way this result goes.
That's great. It starts with an earthquake, birds and snakes, an airplane. Lenny Bruce is not afraid. I have a hurricane. Listen to yourself. Turn world. Serve its own needs. Dummy, serve your own needs. Speed it up a knock. Speak front. No street. The ladder starts to clatter with fear. Fight down high. Wire in a fire. Representatives have engaged in the government for hire in a combat site. Let the West come in a hurry with the fury speeding down your neck. Yeah. My team reporters babble Trump. Tether crop. Look at that. No plane. It's fine. Yeah. Overflow. Population coming through. Save yourself, serve yourself, world, serve the dumb needs. Listen to your heartbeat, dummy, with the rapture and the reverend and the right, right. You patriotic, patriotic, slam, fight, right, my feeling, great sight. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the
true enough, it could be the end of the world. Well, it will be, one way or the other. I lose both of you now.
Why is Stu sitting on his couch like a Hugh Hefner, a British Hugh Hefner?
On the Stu cam. It's going black.
Oh, I have it frozen.
All right. So this is the Cave Crew Radio Election Special. And if you're just joining us, we get sidetracked once in a while, but we are trying to focus on the results of this big election. And the song we played, Big B, was It's the End of the World as We Know It.
That's true.
Either way, bad, good, or indifferent. Do you have an update for us? I love that sound
effect. My update is there is no update at the moment. No new states have been called. Everything is still too close to call in the swing states. So we're just waiting. Trump does hold the lead in all those swing states at the moment, but it is too close to call.
So if everything was to end today, like or not today, but right this moment, Trump would be president elect.
If it all ended right now, Trump would be president, yes.
So let me give you a few questions again as an outsider, assuming things. What can you tell us about the two vice presidents? As an outsider, I don't know shit about them. I've heard them talk a few times, but...
I will tell you that as a person from the States, I don't know shit about either one of them either. Vice presidents generally don't matter. They don't matter to anybody.
President Scott, a.k.a. Gerald Ford...
Yes, if the president dies, the vice president takes over. But I'm just telling you, historically in this country, vice presidents don't matter. What matters is the person that's running for president. Whoever he chooses as vice president, they may hold a little bit of of a weight in the state that they're from, especially if they're from a swing state. But for the most part, nobody gives a shit about Pence. Nobody gives a shit about Kane.
So neither one of them are what the shit they walk in on.
No, no, neither one of them are. I mean, you know, let's look throughout history at some of the recent vice presidents when you had, what's his name now? Whatever his name is, that goofy asshole that's Barack Obama's vice president. Nobody gives a shit about him.
Oh, yeah, we don't even know his name.
I forget his name. I forget all the vice president's name because nobody cares. I mean, Ronald Reagan's vice president was George W. Bush, and he became president. So you know his name. But that's because he became president. If he never
Al Gore. Will you put down the fucking popcorn? I remember Al Gore.
That is true. Trump Gore. Yes, you do remember. That's true. Al Gore. And you only remember Al Gore not because he was vice president, but because he claimed that he invented the internet and he was all in on the, you know, environmental.
Yeah, the save the tree shit.
Yeah, all the global warming shit, but he flies around everywhere in a private jet. So
that's all Clinton money, though, right?
That's all Clinton money. Exactly.
All Clinton money. It's all dirty, and this is why, like you were asking earlier, about how do we feel? Because things will pop up as we talk about different things. Clinton, to me, I can't speak for all Canadians, but I'm not part of the lesbian, gay, bisexual community or anything. And I'm not an immigrant. So the fear doesn't strike me as much, I guess. But they are dirty money. Mm-hmm. They are criminals.
Yep.
Enough has been proven to me, anyway, where... Not that I want Obama to stick around for another year while you guys pick up the football and carry on. Is there no way to impeach these two?
The amazing part is, and that's the sad, sad commentary on this country. Hillary Clinton is the most corrupt politician to ever run for president. She's been investigated by the FBI twice now. She's... You know, it's been all through the WikiLeaks stuff. It's been proven that she bought the Democratic primary from Bernie Sanders. She paid him off. She's, colluded with the networks where they're feeding her questions and they're, letting them know ahead of time what's going to be asked so she can prepare. It's all out in the open and it's all been proven. We can't forget the four that died in Benghazi while she was laying in bed and, not doing a damn thing. Even days before when they were asking for extra security, it was denied by her and the State Department. So it's all out there for everybody to see. But yet all the Hillary supporters don't care. For whatever reason, I don't know why, and I think it's a sad commentary on this country that they don't care. They'll elect basically a criminal into the Oval Office mainly because Donald Trump said pussy, and Donald Trump is mean to women. Which, by the way, let me just mention something here. All the Democrats and all the liberals, Donald Trump is mean to women, and Donald Trump did this, and Donald Trump did that. One, it's not proven. Two, Bill Clinton did. Oh my God.
It's Tuesday. Not only back. It appears he's hooked up his fucking phone. So now we have Stu drunk on his couch. Heaven forbid his wife walks in. Jam number two.
Oh.
Making a note of this.
Real quick, let me just finish my thought. Yes. Bill Clinton has done more things to women. He would make Bill Cosby would blush about the knowing the things that Bill Clinton did to women. Hillary, now, what are we really enabled him?
While you're on him, continue on with your thought, but I want to feed you with this as well. Who is he going to be labeled as? First man, first husband?
I don't know. I don't know.
BBM?
I really
does that automatically make you a cuckold when when your wife becomes president?
That means you
just, does that automatically make you lose your fucking man card or something like?
Absolutely, but you know, to that, what I was saying was, you know, Bill did all this stuff to women, and it's proven he's done all this stuff to women. Hillary enabled him. Hillary defended him. Hillary, you know, publicly disparaged all these women, went after these women, you know, publicly called them names and whatnot, and allowed all this abuse to women by her husband. And yet all the women that are voting for Hillary, oh, well, Donald Trump is mean to women. Have you fucking looked at Hillary Clinton? She's an enabler to a sex fucking, a sex attacker.
Well, don't they go to that pedophile island?
I mean, and that's another thing. I know I didn't read up on that, but that's another thing. The Lolita Express, which there have been rumors for years about Bill Clinton and the Lolita Express, but that's all coming out now on WikiLeaks. I mean, that's really, you know, some fucked up territory. I don't want to say yes or no to that at all. I really hope it's not true, because that's really some fucked up shit. I honestly hope that's really not true. But if it is, you know, that I can't fathom voting for Hillary Clinton and supporting her. And, you know, it's funny. It's funny, too. I know gay people that are with her is the stupid slogan, with Hillary Clinton. She gets money and donations from Middle Eastern countries that burn gays alive because they're gay. And yet, they're all with her because Donald Trump's mean. Are you fucking stupid?
I don't think Donald Trump has one bit of interest in the religious, ethical portion of the Republican Party.
Not at all. None.
I don't think all these things that are against, and I mean, you can swing either way, and you know, Jerry from Bad Cop, we're trying to get a hold of him right now from the Libertarian Center, but sometimes when you're in the middle, it's okay. I like what these guys do. I like what those guys do. I like a little bit of each, but I don't think Trump is going to hurt the people that are against abortions and the saying the Lord's Prayer in the schools or whatever the fuck. I don't know what your problems are over there. He's going to go at this economically and taxes and shit like that.
Yeah, absolutely. He could care less about the religious right. It's all, you know, financial. And another part which I really like is all the government establishment, both parties, Republican and Democrat, are against him. Why? Because he wants to introduce term limits. He wants to get them out of office. He wants new people to come in, new ideas, which I'm all for. But these career politicians don't want to leave their cushy jobs where they make millions from lobbyist money.
Listen, we talk about, like, I don't know, the Vatican, how secret a society that is. Mm-hmm. Donald Trump is the outlander.
Yep.
He is the guy coming in, and whether you like him or you don't like him, he is the average Joe.
Yep.
He's never even sat on city council before. And yeah, he's got an image and a reputation, and people know him as a big businessman and a TV star and whatever. But he is an outsider, mm-hmm, that is giving a little glimmer of hope that maybe if he surrounds himself with the right people, he's going to crack that eggshell. And there's going to be a whole lot more people than Hillary in trouble, both Republicans and Democrats.
Absolutely. And that's why the established government on both sides, the established, you know, Senate and House leaders and representatives are scared shit and don't want him in office. I mean, the Republicans publicly will support him because that's their party guy. They're going to support him publicly. But, you know, behind closed doors, they don't want him in there because they make their living off lobbyist money. They've been in office for 40 years, which... You're in a position of what should be almost volunteer work, giving yourself to the people and you know, representing a certain portion of the people. It shouldn't be a fucking career. You should be in there for, you know, hey, 2 terms, just like the president. 2 4-year terms, you're in, you're out. Replace the government every 4 to 8 years. Replace your new ideas coming in. But no, we're stuck with these people like fucking Harry Reid and all them that have been in office for 40 fucking years. And they're never going to leave because they make all their money. That's why they're scared of Donald Trump. And Donald Trump, if he gets in, no, he's not going to be a great president. Is he going to bring us to war? No, he's not going to bring us to war either. All those people that say, oh, he'll have the launch codes. You know how much fucking approvals you have to go through before you launch nuclear war? It'll never happen.
He's not. Hillary would.
But
Hillary would do it.
But in order to affect real change in this government, it has to start somewhere. And it has to start, it's got to start with Donald Trump. Because if you elect Hillary, it's 8 more years of Barack Obama, George Bush before him, Bill Clinton before him. It's 8 more years of all that shit that really just serves themselves, doesn't serve the people.
We should be ready for an update. Wait a minute. You need something bigger. You got to have something good for us. Here we go.
Well,
it's time now for Cave Crew Radio Election 2016 update. Over to Big B.
The current electoral vote count is Trump 147, Clinton 109.
So he's gaining ground now.
He is widening his lead a little bit. All the 3 swing states are still, again, too close to call.
Now listen, if we're still alive in 2020, we're still doing this, you have to get yourself an interactive map.
If we're still around in 2020, I'm running for president.
Okay, that'd be even better.
I'm on the Cave Crew ticket.
Let's check over to the Stu camp. I don't know if you noticed while you were on your rant, but Stu was giving me a tour of that. I don't want to say his living room because Stu, it looks like he just built that. Are you with us yet, Stu?
Well, I'm on my mobile phone now.
Yeah, we can hear you. You're calling from your mobile phone.
Yeah, so I'm calling from my mobile phone. And I apologize about the technicalities earlier. But I'm back.
Okay, so which room are you in there now?
I'm in the living room.
You're in the living room. You didn't seem to have a lot of furniture in there. Are you turning into a Hindu?
Yeah, it's quite it's quite subtle, the furniture. Even a dog's bed is made out of cardboard.
Now, can you bring us back to those curtains?
I'll tell you what, go on. I'll take you to the curtains.
Yeah.
All right. Hold up.
Oh, thanks for the bell.
Thanks for the bell.
I'll take you to the curtains.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, the audio might be a little low, but this is the Choo Choo Sue number 2 cam, by the way. This is from his phone. He is on remote in his living room right now. Now, look at these curtains, Big. I'm not a fashion expert, but I'm thinking circa 68.
Yeah, 67, 68-ish, sure.
You know, Stu, do you have wallpaper over there in England still?
Yeah, we could wallpaper quite a lot. Yeah.
Wallpaper quite a lot. See, I haven't wallpapered in probably a decade.
But the room I'm in is plastered. Yeah.
Stu, did you break into someone else's house and steal their internet? Because you look really... Look at him, Big B.
This is what they show when somebody like does break into somebody's house and steal things. This is the grainy little video cam. If you see this man, please call Crime Stoppers.
I don't think he is in his own house. That just dawned on me.
Right, and I want to know, is he wearing a shirt under the open Brexit? Oh, he is. Okay.
Yeah.
I just saw it real quick. I saw the open Brexit shirt, and I didn't think he was wearing a shirt on underneath. I thought he was getting all sexy on us.
Now, come back to that shirt again. You got some fat kid on a typewriter or something. What the hell is that?
The fat kid is me, I'm afraid. every week I say I'm going on a diet, and every week I get fatter and fatter. But I'm actually using my neighbour's internet at the moment, so shh, be quiet about that.
I don't think he's in his own house.
He's whispering like he doesn't want to wake the neighbors.
He's using someone else's glass. I think he's. You don't have white leather in your house, and then you certainly don't have curtains like that. You broke into the Hindu's house, didn't you?
And you know what? I think
go to the kitchen. We want to see the kitchen.
I think he's sitting naked from the waist down, sitting on that leather couch.
All right, I'm going to break things up here. I have a guest to bring in, but before I do we have any updates?
We do not. We're at a commercial break right now.
Okay, no updates. We are going to go to one of the swing states right now. Matt, can you hear us?
Yes, I can.
Oh, see? The American knows how to turn on a computer and fucking come on there, you assholes do.
That's because technology hasn't made it across the pond yet.
Well, folks, just so you know, joining us now from Upper Sandusky, Ohio, one of the swing states, the man of 1,000 voices, Matt Vanderpool. If he gets angry, he might switch characters on us. That's okay. But what's happening in Ohio right now? We can't. It's too close to call.
Yeah, what I've seen in the polls and the news, it's awful close. You know, it was projected this is going to be a strong Trump state, but look right now, it's a real close call, and it could be well after midnight before Ohio actually decides who they want for president.
I'm not doing this show for that long, BB.
Yeah, it's like I've been saying, the three major swing states right now, Florida, North Carolina, and Ohio, are all too close to call. What I'm seeing now is Trump has a lead in all three of the states right now. But again, it's too close to call. They haven't gotten all the vote in yet.
Big B is our updater there, Matt. So I got to just educate you on what's going on. Right here, I'm switching to what's called the Choo Choo Stew Cam number 2.
Okay.
Because he can't, he even has freaking Union Jacks on his socks. Oh, my God. You have to come to YouTube, folks. We cannot describe this to you on audio. So anyway, Choo Choo Stu doesn't talk much. So we, hello, Stu. Say hi to Matt.
Hi, Matt.
Hi, Stu.
We just put him on the Chew Cam. And we're gonna try and get like one of those GoFundMes going so we can get a 24-hour Stu Cam. Anyway, how did you feel about the Cleveland Indians losing the World Series that close?
Well, the thing is, I'm not an Indians fan. I'm a Trader. I'm a Tigers fan. So being a Tigers fan, I really didn't want to see the Indians win. But being an Ohioan, I wanted to see the Indians win. And disappointed, they were up by 2 games, and they blew it by 3, you know.
And then they could have won the final as well.
Right, right. Yeah, but they were up by 2 games. All they had to do was win one more game, and they couldn't win one more game. They had 3 games to win one more game, and they could not do it.
Was the feeling in Ohio like, kind of like, of course they lost? We would expect nothing but the Cleveland Indians to blow a 2-game lead and lose.
Believe it or not, no, there was a lot of disappointment because the local mantra was calling them the Windians. Everyone's Windians, we're going to win the series, you know, because everybody's on the high because the Cavaliers won the national championship in basketball, world championship basketball. They're like, okay, that luck is still there. The Indians are going to do it. And no, they did. They got a little taste of the Cleveland Browns luck. So
I have to admit, no update yet.
No. I have to. No update yet.
As a Canadian here, that I love the state of Ohio. I hate Michigan. Absolutely.
I know you do. That's the me. I hate the state of Michigan, except I'm a Tigers fan. You know, I don't ask me why. I was corrupted when I was 8 years old. My mother was a Tigers fan. Most of my family are Tigers or Reds fans. There's not a lot of Indian fans in my family.
Well, that would make sense. Cincinnati. But and anyway, Big B, the state of Ohio does have the Cleveland Cavaliers, who won the basketball.
Right.
And they also have the Ohio State Buckeyes, which I'm an Alabama fan, but my second favorite team is Ohio State. I mean, I think those are the two best programs in the world as far as football goes.
Love my Buckeyes.
What? No.
I love the Buckeyes. I love the Crimson Tide as well.
Boo.
I don't know if someone could put a program together like that for so long. They're probably owned by the Clintons.
Yeah, I want to know, are you a Cleveland Browns fan?
Yes, actually, I am a devout Cleveland Browns fan because you have to be a devout Cleveland Browns to say, with an 0-9 record, yes, I'm a Browns fan.
Now, I can't fathom. They had the number one pick last year in the draft. They traded it, which they should because they need picks and they need players. They're going to get the number one draft pick again this year. Is there ever going to be a time when they're not going to get the number one pick?
Probably not. Probably not. They're getting really good at pissing away that first round draft pick.
They are a god.
The quarterback's going to die.
Listen, if the Chicago Cubs can do it, so can the Cleveland Browns.
Yeah, but it took them 108 years. I'm not going to live that long.
Brother, I'm a Maple Leaf fan since 1967.
Yeah, well, you were around in 1967. You were a couple years old, but you're around in 67.
I don't even think we had fucking TVs in those
days. Well, I mean, let's look at the Cleveland Browns for a second. They had the number one pick going into the draft because they were the worst team in football last year. They traded it away, which, again, they should have because they actually had the third pick.
They had the third pick. They were the third worst team last year.
Oh, who had number one?
I think it was Houston Texans.
Oh, okay. My mistake.
Don't quote me. I could be wrong.
Either way, they were a god-awful team last year. You come into this year, they've had like 16 quarterbacks. They have no running backs. Their best wide receiver is in rehab for beating people and doing drugs. They're a fucking god-awful dysfunctional team.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are. They're like the Bad News Bears of the NFL. And what I don't get, what upset me is they picked up RG3, the most fragile quarterback in the NFL. The most fragile quarterback. You put him behind the worst offensive line in the NFL, and you go, oh, he only made it one game. We thought he'd make it all season. What are you guys fucking smoking in Cleveland?
My favorite thing was I was watching because I watch NFL Red Zone every week. So you see every game. And there was one week where their starting quarterback got hurt, their backup quarterback got hurt. So they had Terrell Pryor, who was a quarterback, converted to wide receiver because he sucks as a quarterback.
I was at that game. It was against the Patriots. They lost Cody Kessler, which was their third string quarterback.
Right.
They lost him. Then Charlie Whitehurst came in, who was Jesus Christ. He lasted three or four downs, and he was done. So they brought Terrell Pryor in. This season, the Browns have gone through six quarterbacks, not counting Terrell Pryor. Six quarterbacks, and it's only game number nine. It's week number 10. Six quarterbacks. What in the hell is going on up there?
Is it too late for them to pick up and move to another state like the original Browns did? I mean, really.
I don't think anybody's taking them. Maybe Vegas. I don't know. Vegas is looking for a professional team, but they're looking for a professional team.
I think my Raiders are going to Vegas.
Yeah, I hope not. Let's keep Raiders in Oakland where they belong.
I'm with you. I'd rather see the Raiders in Oakland, but I really think they're going to move to Vegas in 2 years.
Yeah.
Okay, boys, I hate to interrupt, but let's take a quick break over to the Choo Choo Stew Cam, number two, by the way.
Shooting Jack Sox.
He is sitting in what he claims to be his living room. I don't believe he's. What's going to happen if those people wake up?
Hold up. Am I still there?
Speaking into microphone, Chew.
He's trying not to wake the neighbors because he's in their house.
Stu, oh, Jesus.
How do you keep a day job? All right, anyway, we're going to give Big B a big entrance on this because we're starting to close down here. We got about 30 minutes we can hang out, but let's give Big B a big entrance for his next segment here.
Thank you.
can't ask for more than that.
You really? So,
this is the Patriot Radio election show, and I know it's kind of funny, but that's just us, right? Over to Big B. Let's get an update. Hang on. I didn't get a sound effect. I'm waiting on this all night. Do we have any updates, Big B, in any of the swing states or the who's got the most chairs?
There is no updates in the swing states. However, the electoral vote has changed. Trump remains at 147. Clinton has moved up to 122.
Uh-oh. He's narrowing the gap.
So I don't know. I didn't see which states got called for Hillary, but she's moved up from 109 to 122. So it's 147 to 122, and the swing states are still all too close to call, but still Trump is in the lead.
But now listen, you're not very accurate. You know, you've got what, two colors, red and blue.
Right.
So if there was no red or no blue, then one of them won one of those states. There must be more states coming in by now.
Yeah, I haven't seen it. I'm watching live TV while I'm doing this. I haven't seen it. They're interviewing somebody right now, so they haven't put up which states have been called.
All right. When I call back to you, I'm going to ask for Utah, Nevada, and Idaho.
Well, I will tell you now, Utah and Nevada haven't closed yet. Idaho probably has, but I don't know if there's an update. But Utah and Nevada won't close for maybe another hour or so.
We probably shouldn't have started this show till like 11 o'clock. Stu right now on the Stu Cam, folks, is wandering around in someone's house. I still see where he
threw his pad.
Well, no, look. There's the map, Stu. Go over to that map for a second. We need that. No, not those ugly curtains. Ah, fuck, the map was just up there. Who's that?
So this is what amazes me. Stu is in his neighbor's house in the UK, and yes, we have the US elections on. Canada, DK, where you are in Canada, your national news has the election on. When
yes,
you guys elect your prime minister and your president, whatever it is, we don't give a shit in this country.
Now, if I read that correct, well, of course, we don't affect anything as far as the world goes, other than maybe the world of hockey or something.
Hockey, but, beer, and bacon. We love you for those three things.
Yes, and we also have a lot of tomatoes, a lot of corn, trees, energy. Stu was on the TV there a minute ago, and I could have swore it was a 13-vote spread in Virginia. 13 votes. I might be wrong, but...
Yeah, they've been showing Virginia, too, as very close.
Stu, if I have the... they're not the FBI. What's those people in England who do the...
MI5?
The what?
MI5.
Oh, the MI5 is the FBI. Oh, I think the guy just tackled him. I think he caught Stu. Dude, just run for it.
Stu, run. Run. Don't get
run,
shot.
Run.
There's no one in the UK. Don't get beaten with a billy stick. Run.
Now, Matt, when last I heard from you, you were like retiring from comedy because, you know, you're a volunteer fireman, you're a grandfather now, you're a dad, you're working. Are you still in your comedy?
Yeah, I do a little comedy here and there. I'm still getting guys calling, asking for me to host spots. I mean, when they put $50 in front of me and say, we need you for 15 minutes, I'm like, okay, I'll be there. You know, I feel like a hooker, but now I know what hookers do it, you know. I do have a gig coming up locally the 19th of November here in a big town of Upper Sandusky. It's to help raise money for the local fair board. I only do about 10 minutes, but it's just something I do for the community. And I had said I'm retired. I miss it. But like I said, you know, I've got the fire department. I got EMS. I got a full-time job playing grandpa, playing dad. There for a while, I was taking care of my mom. So things were pretty hectic here, and something had to give, and the easiest thing to give up was the comedy at the time. So,
well, you know what? I think any way you change someone's life, making them laugh is probably one of the most healing powers of all.
Yeah, and I enjoy doing that. And I do get to do that sometimes as an EMT. I mean, I got to be careful. I got to remember this person's sick, but cracking a joke when they've got a knife stuck in their side is probably not the best time because, laughing kind of rubs their ribs. And
look, everything's going to be okay. You've pierced your left aorta. However,
we shouldn't joke. I did stay at a Holiday Inn last night, so you're good to go.
We shouldn't joke about shit like that. Seriously.
No.
I have a small update.
Oh, hang on. I'm not even prepared for that. Sorry, Matt. We're going to have to interrupt for a... a live update from Big B.
As I said, a small update. I don't have any updates on states, but they just flashed the popular vote right now, and Trump is ahead in the popular vote, which is all the votes across the country, 49% to 47%.
But did we not emphasize that that is useless?
It is useless, but it shows where our country at least wants the presidential election to go. Whether it goes there or not is a completely different story.
So basically, you're ready to claim Clinton as president and say, at least we spoke.
Well, I've said that I feel that Clinton has bought and paid for this election already, that she will win. But again, the popular vote right now, which means absolutely nothing as far as electing the president, has Trump ahead 49 to 47.
I swear to God that your beard has grown about 2 inches since the show began. Now, Matt, I got a question for you, and then I'm gonna introduce you into a fun game, because we don't want to have you on the show and just talk about fucking the popular vote and shit like that. But Big B is having popcorn, whiskey, and beer. Like, that's his trifecta for the election. What have you done tonight, or what are you doing now?
What I'm doing now, I had a couple of beers. I had a couple of Bud Lights that had Browns, Cleveland Browns outside the Bud Light can, which is kind of neat because when you open the beer, it tastes like disappointment.
so you got no buzz.
Yeah, I hear the Patriots beer tastes a little flat, but that's another story.
Oh, but
I'm here at 10:30, guys. No, I'm just drinking beer. The wife and I are kind of watching TV, which my wife usually isn't really into politics, but for some reason this election has got the entire country glued to the tube, and she and I were just kind of keeping an eye on watching the election. Our six-year-old grandson's hanging out with us, and he kind of fell asleep. Well, he did fall asleep on us, but he was, he said they had a class vote today in school in the first grade, and 24 kids voted, and 23 voted for Trump, and one voted for Hillary. So I said, did she get banned from recess? So
I know I'm terrible for interrupting, but Big B, I don't know if you're doing the same thing, but with Matt on camera, I was trying to flick these bugs off my screen.
I took them off.
He's got little fruit flies or something. I don't know what
it's like. Something on the wall behind him.
Me?
Yeah, on your right, man.
Oh, they're frame hangers. Sorry, let me just get them out of there.
No! I thought there was bugs on the fucking screen.
It really does look like a bug.
I'm flicking at my screen.
I'm trying to see if this will work right here. That's not helping. That helped a little bit. It's trying to hang my poster here.
Oh, don't worry about it. Now that I know there are hangers on the wall, it's just me hallucinating a little bit.
No, this room is in the remodeling process, which means we've moved the kids out. That's the remodeling process. So.
That's beautiful. All right.
This is the guest room.
I'm gonna introduce you to a brand new game.
And
okay. I'm not going to trust Stu to play this yet. Because all we're doing is getting footage of this house he broke into.
Their fruit flies are gone.
Yeah, the fruit flies. Anyway, Big B.
Yep.
This is the headline.
Uh-huh.
Okay, this is what we play now, Matt. This is a brand new thing we've been doing. Where we used to do weird news where I read a headline and we actually tell the story. There's a guitar in the corner of that, or a quitar, depending on which religion he's... So I read the headline and Big B is going to tell us what the story is without even knowing about it. And then I'll throw it over to you. So watch what he does. So the headline is, Police say man with no hands and no legs is armed and on the run. Please report the story to us.
Yes. So a man in New Mexico who was a quadruple amputee has a gun sitting in his wheelchair, his motorized wheelchair, in between his legs, and he's got no pants on, and he uses his penis to kind of wiggle it around and point it at people. And he blows into the wheelchair to get around. He goes into convenience stores and bars and demands money. And they give him the money just to get him out. And they've reported him that he is armed and dangerous, although the danger being his penis being out. So he is on the run. If you see a wheelchair being blown down the highway, that's your man. Call the police immediately.
How is he on the run?
He's blowing into his wheelchair. He's and it moves.
This story is actually from Florida.
Oh, okay. This is I don't know where, I don't know anything about this story.
So you're just creating your own. You're creating your own story.
I create my own story. That's it.
Gotcha.
And now I'm going to tell you what happened. Authorities in Florida are searching for an armed quadruple amputee.
Yeah, I mean, you can be armed and you don't have any arms, but anywho.
Well, I'm hoping to find that out too. He is Sean Petruzioni, 30. He reportedly lost his legs, hands, and parts of his arms to bacterial meningitis. He moved in with his parents last week. Both his parents were found dead. He was last seen at an ATM surveillance camera. Well, this is getting good.
What's he doing? Punching his pin number like a woodpecker with his nose. Beep, beep, beep.
So he's killed his parents with a gun. He's also armed with a gun. I'm trying to imagine a quadriplegic doing this, and I'm not trying to be sick, folks.
I'm trying to picture myself. I'm not trying to be sick either. I'm with you, DK.
There was a prosthetics expert that told the Orlando Sentinel, you don't need a hand to shoot both your parents, just the will, as most guns apparently can be fired by the handless.
Damn you, Smith & Wesson. Damn you.
You know, we're going to rename this segment to Truth or Fiction.
There you go.
Well, see, you know that game you play where you got to guess who, you know, you're all given in a circle and you're writing a word from the dictionary?
Yep. Fiction or fact?
Yeah. Fiction or fact. We're going to change it next week. Anyway, here is your headline, Matt.
All right.
Perhaps not a conversation for the staff room. A student teacher aged 24 reveals she had to undergo surgery to remove a sex toy from her bottom. In a very awkward Facebook post. Matt, how does this story read?
Susie McButtsmacker from Tallahassee, Florida, has recently gone to the emergency room to have a prosthetic toy, prophylactic toy, removed from her derriere. It seems that this young professor at Florida State University had a mishap at a party. Tripped over a cat carrying her prophylactic little toy, and next thing you know, it's where it's not supposed to be. But sources say it's not a phallic sex toy; it's a fist, a big purple throbbing fist. And she actually went to the ER to have it removed, and then decided after the ER that maybe she'd just leave it there for a while.
She liked the fist.
Yeah.
See, this is a fun little game we invented, folks. Here's what really happened. The student teacher was forced to undergo surgery to remove a 7-inch pink sex toy after it became lodged in her bottom.
She was in her ass. Bill Patriot game, wasn't she?
Yeah.
Was that her ass? Got tossed on the field?
Here's the part that really bothers me is why do these people allow their names to be published?
And who cares if she's a student teacher?
We all know now that Emma Phillips, 24, got a 7-inch pink dildo stuck up her ass.
Whereas my,
a prophylactic election.
What state was this from, DK? Florida?
Let me see. It quite possibly could be.
Or Iowa.
I now have an issue, guys. Why do you publish your name when you do something like this?
I wouldn't.
Looking for
it's the age of instant celebrity, so of course they're going to publish their name. They want to be famous.
Like, and she's posing for all these fucking pictures. Like, I have a dildo stuck up my ass, not my vagina.
What is Stu doing?
I don't know, but you know what else I just thought of, and this is a terrible thing to say, but I'm just wondering. If you kiss or have oral sex with, what's the donkey's name again, the kid?
What?
What?
Who's Hillary's kid?
Oh, Chelsea.
If you kiss or have oral sex with Chelsea, is that considered anal sex? I have never seen anyone so ugly in my entire life. Now we're over to Choo Choo Stewart. I think he's back on the grid. He looks like he's in a dentist chair now.
I think he's sitting there like you should be being cooled with a fig leaf and people feeding him grapes.
Well, I hope he's running his flex bit as many fucking steps he's taken the last half hour.
Can you fucking update us from whatever? Are you in a leather hammock now? On your boredom, wah.
Right. Here we go.
Yeah, we're here. We've been here all night.
I haven't got my headphones on. I'm trying to eliminate any problems.
How can you hear what we're saying then?
Yeah, I can hear you.
That wasn't the question. Stu.
I look like, a head on this big fat fucking body. Shh. Yeah.
Okay. I want to read you a news story before we go to our next and probably our final update of the night.
Oh my God.
Did you hear about you know what a Toblerone chocolate bar is, right, Stu?
Yep.
Looks like he's on fucking heroin or something.
He's fucking shit-faced.
So Toblerone has decided to shrink their chocolate bar. So you know how they're all formed in triangles, right?
Exactly.
Exactly, yeah. Probably hasn't seen a Toblerone in his whole fucking life. Anyway, they are shrinking so the triangles are getting smaller and the flat piece in between is getting bigger. They're trying to scam people, but they're not going to raise the prices.
Well, why would they?
Because they're giving less chocolate, so they're actually making more of a profit.
But all the companies are doing that, DK, aren't they?
Well, I don't know. This is why we're asking you. You are a business expert tonight. Okay, the Death Star has been struck again. Extraterrestrial fucking Tourette's, I'm telling you. I never even want to visit England. Ever. I think eating those eels out of that fucking dirty lake really did you in, brother.
Still go via not Canada.
No, I think that the show that you went on in front of Big B and I eating eels and what was it, Big B, lemon juice and
the green vomit sauce, yeah.
Oh, I'm not talking about the time you ate the eels.
Oh, yeah.
Like a moray eel.
Yeah.
It's in this fucking system.
It should have. There's some things you just don't freaking eat.
look at Stu. He looks so relaxed with his arm behind his head.
He's just relaxing.
Relaxed as all hell in somebody else's house.
He's like, look at these dumb North Americans.
Somebody else's house. And I'm thinking of my
next door neighbors.
I know
your wife at the Wally.
That's why you won't sleep. No. You've got heels disease.
And he said, can I look after his place while he's away?
So you're supposed to be watching his house, and you're sitting there wiping off on his leather furniture, drinking his booze.
Can we sneak a goat into his house? Can we please find a home for these fucking goats?
No, I'm just doing what any neighbor would do, is just keeping an eye on his place.
Yeah, and you brought your microphone and everything. That's what I think. I just happen to have my 8-foot microphone with me. That's what you used to break the fucking window, didn't you?
I don't need to break the window. I had the keys to his house before he had them.
Well, why'd you throw the mic on the ground? No matter, it doesn't work.
No, that just fell when I tripped over.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, listen, we still have time, but we won't do an update yet because there's probably no news. What else can we bug Matt about? Matt, I don't know what else to talk to you about. It's been a long time. We haven't done any of your characters yet.
No, we haven't.
Have you integrated any of your characters from, like, all the radio you've... Because Matt's actually been doing this on and off for about 6-7 years with us, I think.
Yeah, that's about right.
I've not
used them in my act. I mean, I do goofing around with buddies at work or hanging out at the bar or hanging out at the club or at the game, but I've never actually brought the characters on stage.
What about doing something like that? Who's that guy that has the puppets?
Oh, Jeff Dunham?
Well, yeah. I have a big update.
Oh, hang on. I am not ready. Folks, please hang on for just a minute. I was not expecting one. Over to Big B with a big election update.
As you know, we were talking about the three swing states, Florida, North Carolina, and Ohio. Right now, Matt, this is for you. The Ohio swing state is projected to go to Trump.
Yes.
So now Trump goes up in the electoral race 168 to 109.
Oh, wow. Ooh.
The people are talking.
For Donald Trump.
Nothing from Florida or North Carolina or Michigan.
Nothing from Florida, North Carolina, or Michigan. All too close to call, but they just called Ohio.
So we're now saying Ohio is Trump.
Ohio is Trump. That's what we're saying, yes.
Awesome.
So as an Ohio person... And people that you talk to on a daily basis, how is Ohio going to respond to this?
I think Ohio is going to be very happy because Ohio is a very strong industrial state between farming and factories. And we a lot of the chit chat that I've heard in chatter, we need somebody with a business background to run this country for a little bit.
So. Now, let me ask you, Matt, because Big B and I talked about this off the onset. And Stu chimed in with a couple bing, bong, bong, eh. And that. What is the up and what is the down of the two?
The up and the down. The up. If there is- the down of Trump is he just needs to learn to shut his damn mouth. He runs his suck too much. He says dumb shit he shouldn't say. A lot of what's got him, people mad at him, is things that he's said. Not things he's done. People are pissed at Clinton because of things that she's done, not things that she's said. You know, and I think what's pulling her, getting her votes, is that she's a woman. I've heard so many women say, "I'm voting for her because she's a woman." That shouldn't be the reason you vote for somebody because of their sex, their race, their religious background. You should be voting on somebody because of what they stand for. Like I said, but you know, most people are upset with Trump because of what he said. And most people are upset with Clinton because of what she's done or what she's been accused of doing.
And you know what? You should be mad at something for what they've done.
I agree. I've said shit that I wished I hadn't said. And thank God, or at least I hope there wasn't somebody recording it. It comes back to bite you sometimes. And, you know, some of the things you said is inappropriate. And I think a lot of times he just speaks without thinking because he's Donald Trump. He's always had the money to do that. He hasn't had to worry about what he said because – he can tell people to go screw, go fly a kite, go because he's got the money to tell them to do that. But now, as
everything bad you've said, yeah, and I've got it on a little disc. So should you ever run for president, it's going to come out, man.
The only thing Choo Choo Stew has said in the past hour, he's playing secret agent from his neighbor's house.
That's right. Matt, I want to ask you, being here in the U.S., so you see it more than obviously DK or Stu for sure. I've said all along that it's shameful that especially the women vote for Hillary because Trump said pussy. He said bad things. But Hillary has enabled her husband to assault women. She's defended her husband amongst these allegations and disparaged these women that it's come out that he did actually assault her. But yet women will back Hillary because Trump said bad things.
Yeah, and that confuses me. That completely confuses me. You know, she is supporting a womanizer, but at the same time making derogatory comments about another womanizer.
Right.
You know, so she's being a hypocrite.
It doesn't make sense. And her supporters just turn a blind eye and don't care. Oh, Trump said bad things, blah, blah, blah. I don't care what Hillary's done or said.
Right, right. And I think that's my biggest problem with Hillary is the things that she's done and people just like, oh, it's no big deal. You know, 7 Americans were killed in Benghazi. You know, it's just 600,000 some emails that just weren't classified, just disappeared, you know. So, you know, they've got – so I think it was the New York Post put out a 3-page paper of all the wrong things that Trump has said, all the derogatory things he said in this 15 months. Right. But yet there's no New York Times doesn't have enough paper to print all the emails that disappeared out of Clinton servers.
Right. And even the let's bring it down to a fundamental thing. Hillary Clinton says that she was hacked and whatever, blah, blah, blah. Let's put all that aside. Let's concentrate on one thing that she said in defending herself amongst this email scandal. She didn't know that the C in brackets stood for classified. This is the Secretary of State, the head of the State Department. She wants to be President of the United States. You don't know that a C means classified information?
I'm completely with you.
This is the person you want running this country that she's admitting she's so fucking stupid in government that she doesn't know that a C in brackets means classified. Now, I wouldn't know that because I'm not in government. You guys wouldn't know that because you're not in government. She was the Secretary of State, the head of the State Department.
Right.
One of the top 5 in the chain of command of this country. She doesn't know that the C means classified.
Yeah. All right. Listen up, guys. Listen up. We have time for one more update.
Don't do it.
And then I am going to ask you all 2 questions to close out the special Cave Crew Radio. Over to Big B for our last night.
The very latest update is that Hillary wins Virginia. So the electoral race now stands at 168 for Trump, 122 for Hillary.
It's still a lead. All right, boys. So here's what's going to happen now. Cave Crew Radio 2016 election special is what you've been listening to, folks, or watching on Cave Crew Radio TV on YouTube. I hold up this red light. The first question is, okay, you got to call it now. I'm going to go to each of you, and based on what you see and what you believe and what you feel, not what you want, I want you to project the race that is too close to call. Let's go to England and see if he can get out 2 words.
We would go to me first, wouldn't you?
Yep.
I'm here.
The question is A or B, it's Trump or Clinton?
Trump or Clinton. That's my prediction.
No, you have to legibly say it for your vote to count.
Oh, I'm predicting Trump.
No, I don't want you to put it in the form of a sentence. I want you to give me 1 or 2 words because it'll come across clear. Trump or Clinton?
Trump.
All right, there you go, Trump. Let's go over to our guest in Upper Sandusky, Ohio. What are you claiming here?
Trump.
You guys really feel this with your heart.
Yes.
All right, over to Big B, our political expert of the night.
My heart and what I really want is Trump, but I know Clinton is going to win just because I feel that she's bought and paid for this election.
You know what? I really don't know either, but because I'm scared. I don't want Clinton to get in again, but I'm really feeling some Trump magic tonight. So hopefully a 3-1 vote, even though one of us is English and the one's Canadian, between Ohio
my gut feeling is with Big B there in New York, and I'm going with him.
Did you just want extra airtime? Is that why you're like, did something happened in the past 15 seconds that you decided that Hillary's going to win?
He's relaxing with his arm behind his head. You know, he's feeling pretty good.
I'm just going with Big B. I knew he would have the right thought, but it's going to be Trump anyway.
Which one is it, though?
I don't know.
All right, I said Hillary.
This is what just happened.
Exactly.
Yes.
I can't vote for them.
Mr. Stu just said that he was going to vote for Trump. He thought Trump was going to win. Then he interrupted as we were going to our final segment and said, I'm going to go with Big B, but I really think Trump is going to win. So you're a hypocrite. Your vote is disqualified.
Yep.
I really think this extraterrestrial threat you have is rubbing off. Now we have another favorite part of the show. And since the camera's on you, Stu, go ahead as you're looking at the stars. What would you name the election special?
I deliberately never put pen to paper because I just thought it would be election special.
There you have it. Choo-choo Stu votes that the episode has no subtitle. And it is named Election Special. I'm going to go to myself this time because I usually have a hard time. I'm just going to call this one. I had written down about the prophylactic erection or election, whichever way you wanted to put it. I could put it prophylactic erection or election. And then I also had too close to call. Over to Matt.
Election dysfunction.
Which one?
Election dysfunction.
Election.
Like erectional dysfunction.
Electoral.
Actually, should do in honor of Stu. We should call it.
I don't know how I spelled that.
No, I actually liked yours. I liked yours, DK.
I kind of like electoral dysfunction as well. Prophylactic erection or electoral dysfunction. Over to you, Big B. What would you call it?
I have, along the lines of Matt's thinking, I have extraterrestrial election Tourette's.
Damn it. You gotta damn it.
Extra. Terrestrial.
Election Tourette's.
Election. This is a lot to write. All right, I'm going to disqualify yours because you didn't have one, Stu, but I'll give you the first vote. We've got electoral dysfunction, prophylactic erection, or extraterrestrial election Tourette's. What do you think, Stu?
I'm going to go for the third one.
Did you say the third one?
Yeah.
Give me a thumbs up if you're voting for extraterrestrial election Tourette's. Yes, okay. Okay, Matt.
I'm with Sir Big B. I like his too. Tourette's. I like the Tourette's.
All right, just because we're running over tonight, I'm going to agree. So it's. Help me with this again. Extraterrestrial election Tourette's.
Right.
Right. I don't even know if I can fit that on the on the title, but I'll try. So anyway, folks, too close to call. 3-1 Trump, if you include the people that don't live in the country, but it's an even draw. And Matt go. One says Trump, one says Clinton. So at the time you're listening to this, by the time it turns into a podcast or a YouTube video, better than us. I don't think we're doing a show Thursday because Big B's away. Going on Facebook Live. Cave Crew Radio 2016 election special. Special Tuesday as opposed to a Thursday. CaveCrewRadio.com or Cave Crew Radio, or sorry, Cave Crew TV on YouTube. Matt, closing words.
Thanks for having me. It's been a long time since I hung out with you guys. It's always a pleasure. Even if it's only in like this, but it's always great to catch up with you guys and appreciate the chit chat. Thanks for the talk about football there, Sir Big B. That helps my, it's a coping mechanism. It helps me get through until next Sunday. So.
Awesome. Awesome. And you know what? Speaking of Stu, he's always telling the best stories when he cuts out. Stu, 6 words or less, please.
Maybe just have him do flashcards next time.
Stu? Thumbs up.
I'm here. This is now live.
Okay. We'll see you next time too, Stu. Big B, can you top that?
No, I really can't. I will say, I will give one final update. Hillary is projected to win Colorado, so the electoral votes is now 168 to 131.
Getting closer, folks. You should have heard this first. I apologize. You'll forever remember that in your sleep, everyone. All right, folks, it's been our election special. We're sorry we can't give you a result, but it was nice to have Trump in the lead for a while, even if it doesn't last. Big D in New York, Choo Choo Stew, and Lord the fuck knows where. Strawberry Fields forever. And my good friend Matt Vanderpool, the man of 1,000 voices. This is DK signing off. See you next week. All right, boys. We are clear.
All right. Thanks for letting me play again, guys. It's good catching up with you.
Yeah, we'll get you back over the